All right, so here I am shopping for the last time in a year. Here's my shopping list. Since I live an hour from a Safeway, I usually stock up pretty good. And I usually go shopping every like 3 weeks or every month or so.
Zombies are just really blood dripping, horny people. You know, you get so drunk and you want to, like, you're so turned on and you want something. It's like that. It's like that feeling.
It's like that, but it's blood. And
it's
that's
like
what
that, but it's blood and flesh. And it's like, it's really intense. And you can't stop it.
Bloodlust.
Blood and lust.
Yeah.
Blood and lust.
A sexual urge to eat human flesh. All right, it's just after 1 a.m. on September 22nd, and I'm turning almost all these to off. All except for that one that says back wall. That's my one outlet I'm gonna use for my computer. And I guess I just turned my fridge off too. That's kind of funny. It's 7 a.m. and I realize now that maybe I should have got more coffee. Anyways, I'm gonna have to quit drinking coffee, which is gonna suck. But not this morning, so I'm gonna try and make a cup of coffee. Morning, I guess my main task is to inventory my house and show you guys how much food I have so that we know a baseline for the experiment. Let me tell you, inventorying your house really, really sucks, dude. I mean, look at all this crap. Is it even worth noting whether I have, you know, like a half a thing of 500 milliliter mouthwash? All right, I'm going to show you very quickly how to make a poke bowl. I got this piece of bamboo, it's about 10 feet long maybe, and also a clothes hanger, duct tape, pair of pliers, and Zid drill gun. So for the leader, I'm gonna take this, bend it over, and then twist it around a couple times. Then put the wire through there. Now, you just tie on your leader, stick it in a hole in the rocks, and see if you can pull out a fish. So, it's gonna be really embarrassing if that doesn't happen tomorrow.
I've let these praying mantises go like 6 months ago, and I've seen them a couple times, and they've been like an inch long. And this guy is like 5 inches long. He's huge. He looks like he's gonna fall off the ceiling and attack me or something. It's awesome.
For some reason, a lot of people are obsessed with me not shaving for a year and wearing skins and all this weird stuff. Even though, you know, I have shaving cream, I have razors that I could shave until they run out. This is the first day, so I'm gonna shave and we'll see how long it lasts. Alright, there you go. Is that the last time I shave in the year? I don't know. I guess we'll find out.
We're hiking out to a secret destination to have our, I think, 13th annual Guys Night ritual, which got a little wild last year. I got my tires slashed and someone shit on the hood of my car. And now we're going. Alright. So, I got a little yarn hook on my leader. And I'm gonna stick this bitch out in a hole somewhere. And hopefully, there'll be a fish on it when I come back. Like little mice, hiding in the refrigerator. That is a nice snow. It's not an animal, it don't have legs. Here's my poke hole. Is there anything on it? No. Nothing. I've caught nothing. Failure. So all of our extra scraps from drying these pears are gonna get fed to the worms in the wormery. Worms love like fruit scraps, it's like their favorite thing. And so next spring, this will be compost for the garden. In addition to cutting up my pears and drying them, I'm also going to try and make some pear brandy. So I've chopped up half a pickle bucket of pears, kind of smashed them. I'm gonna add a packet of active yeast. This is just bread yeast, nothing fancy. And I'm gonna fill it full of water. And we will see if it ferments and turns into something that we can distill. I've never tried it. This is a ham, cheese, and tomato sandwich. I'm making one for dinner today and one for lunch tomorrow. And that is the last of my ham. I ran out of sausage yesterday. It's Wednesday, so it hasn't even been near a week. I'm pretty much almost out of perishable stuff at this point. And this ham's been unrefrigerated for about 5 or 6 days, which is kind of scary. But it only smells a little weird. The cheese is, I had to cut some mold off. The cheese is pretty gnarly. But still eating pretty good week one. So I just woke up and it's like 2 or 3 in the morning and I hear this scratching noise. And I came out and there was a skunk in my kitchen digging around in my last bag of garbage. My entire house is built around this giant oak tree right here. And so, it being fall, it's been raining acorns all over my deck. So, I'm gonna pick these things up and store them in a garbage can with some bay leaves to keep the weevils out. And that might be my food when all my rice and pasta and other starchy stuff runs out. I just walked out of the health center from getting my health screening results. Currently I'm relatively healthy, pretty normal. And I saw that on the ground here, there's lots of acorns. So, I'm gonna do a little acorn harvest while I'm here. If you take these and split them open, you see there's a chestnut in there. Those are much more desirable than acorns, but there's a lot less, so I'm collecting those while I'm down here too. Alright, today's task is to clear out some of this jungle that's grown up over the summertime so I can get my fall garden in. Alright, week one hasn't been too rough. I'm having a healthy portion of yogurt, strawberries, and granola pretty much every morning. Not very interesting yet, but I'm eating my perishable foods. So after that, it's gonna go slowly downhill, I imagine.